It's becoming clear that some sort of tax reform is going to be a priority in Wisconsin in the next couple of years. Governor Walker has stated his interest in cutting or even eliminating the state income tax, but that might lead to a hike in the state sales tax, something Democratic gubernatorial candidate Mary Burke called a job killer last week. A few Republican state lawmakers are pushing the idea of a sales tax holiday. So what really is going to be possible or likely? We're asking Todd Berry, the president of the Wisconsin Taxpayers Alliance. Todd, good to have you back on the program.
Good to be back.
So you understand Madison. You know the way it works. What are the odds of the elimination of the income tax actually happening in Wisconsin?
Well, to put the numbers on the table, last year we collected about $7.5 billion in personal income taxes. And if you add the corporate income tax to that, it's almost $8.5 billion. And you cannot separate the two when you get into the nitty-gritty. So if you're doing nothing else but increasing the sales tax, you're probably going to almost triple the rate.
It's about 13 cents.
Well, if with the corporate income tax, you'd be
even
closer
more.
To 15, yeah. So if you don't do that, you've really got to do something that politicians hate, and that is you've got to stop carving up every tax like it was Swiss cheese. You can't exempt all the things that are being exempted.
We have a long list of exemptions for the sales tax in Wisconsin.
Yeah.
Would you say it makes more sense to have a lower rate and a much broader application of the sales
Always.
Tax?
Always. In any tax. And the politicians never get that. They'd much rather carve out little things, make the law more complex. And taxes are a kind of regulation, so they're really making regulation more difficult. And then sooner or later, it's going to push up the rate. I think that billion-dollar tax increase in 2009, in part, was about the recession. In part, was all the diddling they had done in the years before that put pressure on the tax.
We hear about other states mm-hmm. not having an income tax, Washington State, for
mm-hmm.
example. But Washington State's, again, the application of the sales tax is much different than Wisconsin.
Yeah. If you look at the states that don't have an income tax, they all spend less per capita than we do. They've made a choice. I mean, that is one choice we could make. Mm-hmm. One way to help pay for no income tax is we don't spend as much. But the state that's most like us is Washington. And the way they do it is, yes, they have a higher rate, but they tax a lot more stuff than we tax. I mean, you get into stuff like real estate sales, food, you know, a lot of sacred cows. You can't get there unless you're really willing to have a very broad base tax.
The argument for this, people who favor changing the way we tax in the mm-hmm. state is that our income tax is too high, property taxes are too high, sales tax tends to be below average.
Yeah.
We could change the mix.
Mm-hmm.
Is that likely to be part of the conversation in terms of maybe not raising the sales tax by mm-hmm. 5 or 6 or 7 cents, but maybe raising it 2 cents, and in return, knocking down property taxes some, knocking down the income tax some?
Yeah. Well, there's no question that there's a need for tax reform in that we haven't had a comprehensive discussion in decades. And you're right, the property tax and the income tax in this state are both about 25% higher than the national average. And the sales tax is, well, we rank 35th. It's about 15% below. So you could do this kind of balancing. And in fact, interestingly, the current revenue secretary mentioned that idea a few years back.
Back in 2010.
Before he became revenue secretary. And when he became revenue secretary, they asked the governor about that. And he said, well, I don't think so. So
you've talked and written about the fact that maybe we should be looking at a different kind of tax, like a European-styled VAT tax, a consumption tax. Does that stand any chance of being considered?
It's not an idea that's going anywhere in the United States, but it happens in the provinces of Canada, and it happens in many places in Europe. But you would never call it a European-style VAT.
It's dead on arrival,
but
if you say that.
What
it
really is it's a way to do a sales tax without having to fight over every little exemption and without placing burdens on businesses that are selling and buying from each other. You don't want the tax to pyramid as it moves through the production chain.
Before we go, I've got to ask mm-hmm. you a quick question about the prospect of a sales tax holiday. Your organization's stance on that?
Well, we don't take stands, but I will tell you that if you look at all the various research groups and think tanks in Wisconsin and around the country, whether they're on the far right, the far left, or anywhere in between, none of them support a sales tax holiday, and they all say for the same reason, basically, it's pretty bad tax policy.
Todd Berry is the head of the Wisconsin Taxpayers Alliance. Good to have you back on the program. We appreciate it. Next, our most abundant natural resource, why we shouldn't take it for granted.